The cartwheel, possibly one of the most iconic freestyle kayak moves, and one that you can do in a variety of boats and situations. As usual, we're going to start off here with an overview of this move before breaking it down into smaller steps. Start with a double pump. In a neutral, upright seated position, take one big stroke forward to pull the bow up, then slam it back down with a big back sweep stroke. When you're vertical, look over your shoulder and rotate your body ahead of where you're going to throw your stern. For your right cartwheel, this would be your right shoulder, then follow through with the stern. When the stern hits the water, push off the water with the other blade to complete the rotation and finish the move. Alright guys, that's the quick rundown done. Now we're going to get into a more detailed explanation and break down each part of the cartwheel. To initiate a cartwheel, start with a few forward strokes to gain a little bit of speed, then drop some edge. Next, you want to perform a double pump stroke to get into the cartwheel. Look upstream. As you're pulling on the first stroke of the double pump, rotate your upper body with the direction of the stroke to pull the blade through the water. At the same time, tense your core, hip flexors and glutes to drive your lower body in the opposite direction and pull your knees up. This should pull the bow up and out of the water, similar to how you open a jar. You're twisting the bottom half in one direction and the top half in the other. When the bow of the kayak reaches its highest point out of the water, slam it back down using the same muscles in your lower body as before. Roll your wrists forward and start to push down on the surface of the water with the back of the blade. You're essentially using your paddle as a lever to kickstart this rotation. The push stroke should coincide with the downward rock of your bow. The full blade should be pressing against the water just as the bow starts to hit the water. There may be a slight pause between the two strokes of the double pump as you wait for the bow to start falling. Keep pushing until the boat reaches a vertical position. Now you need to throw the next end. Lift and bend your elbows to take the paddle off the surface of the water. At the same time, roll your wrists back. Rotate your body, looking over your leading shoulder until you're looking upstream. Pull your boat with your lower body to follow through with the rotation until the stern hits the water. Your elbows should drop again at this point to lower the blades to the surface of the water. You can now use the other blade of your paddle to assist in completing the maneuver by giving a quick push of the paddle face off the surface of the water. This can also help to stabilize the kayak while you finish the move. Sit up to bring the kayak flat and complete the maneuver, or stay in a neutral position to continue throwing more ends. Okay guys, a little troubleshooting for you now. So the first thing I would check is how much you're edging. If you're not edging enough, it'll be hard to push the bow underwater. On the other hand, too much edge and you'll probably just fall over. If you push the back of the blade down too soon or too early, it'll require a lot more effort to force the bow down. You might end up capsizing or just coming back down. Ask someone to watch you while you do this to see how your timing is, or try filming yourself if you can. During the cartwheel, you should be sitting upright in a neutral position during most of the move. If you lean too far forward, you'll flatten out, and if you lean too far back, you might fall on your face. When you get your first cartwheels, you might notice that you're veering off slightly to one side.
Go. You did?
The perfect cartwheel.
Okay, maybe it doesn't look that bad, but if you'd like to try to counteract this, try to remember to look upstream while you're throwing your ends so that you can better spot where you're landing and keep control of the direction you're heading in. This is particularly important when you're linking lots of cartwheels together or other moves so that you can stay in a nice straight line. One of the most important parts during the cartwheel is making sure that your body's rotation is always ahead of your boat. If the boat catches up, you can't unwind to throw the next end, and that'll be the end of your cartwheel. Okay, moving on to some more advanced moves or links that might be of interest. Cartwheels link together naturally, so this can be a fun way to progress this move. It's also a good way to prepare for the more advanced moves that require taking strokes from the stern stall position, such as the lunar orbit and tricky woo. To continue cartwheeling after the second end, you have to be able to slam the bow down while you're in the stern stall position. This requires you to balance on your stern without support from your paddle. You take this split second of free balancing to wind up your body for the next end. Roll your wrists forward, look upstream, and start to push on the water with the back of your blade. You can continue cartwheeling here as long as you can stay in a straight line and keep that momentum up. If you're comfortable with your cartwheel, it can be fun to try clean cartwheels. The difference here is just that you're allowed to use one blade of the paddle. It starts off the same as before. The only difference is that for the second end, you keep the paddle out of the water and rely on your body to maintain the momentum from the previous end. This is actually a pretty good exercise as it forces you to focus on your body movements and timing instead of relying on support from your paddle. Another fun variation of the cartwheel is the hand cartwheel. Similar to the clean cartwheel, this can help to improve your form. It's also a fun way to mix up your training session and a good incentive to learn or practice your hand roll. But you should mainly be using it to flex on your peers, obviously. To initiate it, do a double pump with your hands the same way you would with a paddle. Here's a little trick with the hand cartwheel. Use your other hand to push down on the bow on the opposite side of the boat that you're edging. This will make it easier to get the bow down during the double pump. Finally, a personal favorite cartwheel variety of mine is the paddle toss and catch. This starts off in the same way as the regular cartwheel, until you get vertical. Basically, you just need to leave the paddle down on the surface of the water and do a clean end, and then catch the paddle again. You can actually push the paddle forward in the water a bit so that it meets you as you're rotating around. You'd be surprised with just a little bit of practice that you can actually get kind of consistent on this. Alright, well that's it for today guys. Hope this helps with your cartwheel in some way. The cartwheel really is a great way to get into freestyle and opens up a lot of possibilities. Hope you have fun playing around with it, and see you next time. Thanks.